special visitor, Char Margolis, our intuitive medium, is in the house, and we're so excited to have you here.
Thank you. I love being here.
Well, we love that we are going to talk a little bit about intuition, and it's one of those things that all of us have. We've talked about this before on the show, but maybe we're not tapping into it as much as we should be.
I don't think we talk about intuition enough because we always have to be reminded of things. Mm-hmm. So animals have instinct, people have intuition. Now, it's that time in your life where you wanted something, maybe it was a romance, maybe it was a business thing, and a gut feeling said, don't do it. Yeah. Well, you went and you did it anyway, and you suffered the consequences. So what my goal is to teach everybody to listen to their own intuition, because the future changes at any moment, at any second, because of someone else's choice or decision. So we need to be in sync in the moment, because not everything in life is predestined. We accrue our karma by our deeds and by the choices we make. Mm-hmm. So I wanted to give a couple tips about intuition, if I may.
Yeah, let's talk about it.
So the main thing that I talk about are the four C's. Mm-hmm. To have the courage to accept your intuition and the courage to make a mistake.
Right, which is, I think, what a lot of us are afraid of, and which is why we're ignoring that
and
voice.
And it's that gut feeling. It's that gut feeling that we have that goes sometimes against all logic. Mm-hmm. The courage, the confidence, mm-hmm. to use it. Commit yourself to using it, and then you'll conquer it. But to conquer it, the hardest thing is to act upon it.
Right.
Now, I wanted to ask you an example that you've had about your intuition.
Okay, so I am definitely practical, probably to a fault. So for me, I'm always looking at the list and the rules, and this is what I'm going to follow. So I think I'm a big ignorer of my gut instinct.
Okay.
But recently, just a couple of months ago, even though I'm at my parents' house all the time, I always call. I just call. Mommy, Daddy, I'm coming over. I'm going to, you know,
sweet,
the kids want to see you, blah, blah, blah. And they're usually like, fine. There was one Saturday that came around, and I said to my husband, I got to go see my parents. And he's like, well, you know, you're complaining that you're so busy, and this, you got to do this, that, and the other thing. Why not take that off your list? Like, you don't have to go today. And I'm like, you know what? I want to go. I'm going to bring the kids, and we're going to go. And I didn't call them, which is weird. And I don't even know why I didn't call them.
Wow.
So I stopped at the grocery store. I bought food, because I always want to bring food, because, you know, my mom's the main cook for my dad, and it's nice for her to have a break every once in a while.
So sweet.
So I stopped and got some food, and I'm thinking to myself, maybe I should call now. And I didn't call. And I'm like, come on, kids, let's get in the car. We get in the car, we get all the way to Richmond Hill, which is just outside of Toronto, and I ring the doorbell, and no one answers, and I use my key. And I go in there, and the house is quiet. My parents are both retired, and, you know, according to me, they're not supposed to do anything. They're just supposed to be there waiting for me. So I'm like, where are they? So about 45 minutes went by. I made my kids lunch, and then I thought, let me call them. I called my dad's cell phone. Sure enough, they're in the emergency room at the hospital.
Oh, my goodness.
So something had gone wrong with my mom's medication for blood pressure.
But you had a feeling.
I knew it. It's like I knew I had to go to their house that day. And even my husband was saying, it's too much. You're doing too much today. And I'm like, no, 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 I got to go.
That's a great example, because sometimes it's taking that extra step.
Right.
And using up that extra energy when we're tired, when you say, no, you got to do it now, you got to listen to it.
Yeah.
And, you know, that's a wonderful example. And thank you for sharing it, because everybody has intuition. And I was talking to Tracy, who did my makeup. Thank you, Tracy. And she was saying, you know, I get this gut feeling like if something's not right, like if a guy is cheating on me or whatever, she goes,
yeah,
I get a gut feeling, and like you kind of feel sick to your stomach, and it happens. I
mm-hmm.
mean, I'll be in the best mood and I'll be great, and I'll go, oh, that person is not being honest with me or truthful or kind to me.
Listen.
And you listen because time proves that your instincts were right.
Yeah.
So if I can give anybody a gift in life that you already have that costs nothing, is to listen to your intuition, and most of all, act upon it.
Act on it.
Yeah.
Act on it. Yeah. So we spent the day in the hospital, but I was so happy we were there. You know, like
it
was so good to be there, and there was a reason why.
But that's what this is all about.
Yeah.
And it's hard to explain it to people unless you experience it. And the more you experience it, the more you do it. What if you had not acted on your intuition?
Right. And then knowing my parents, they would have never complained. I would have found out about it the next
day.
By the way, we were at the hospital. Like, I'm happy I got there. And I think a lot of us don't be like me and be so worried about getting the thing on the list, the checklist done.
Right.
Listen to what's happening internally. Tracy Peart has amazing gut instincts, and she always lets that guide her in her life.
But if you hadn't done it, you would have gone, ugh, I knew it, and I should have done it. How many people have had that experience? Oh, I did it. Raise your hand.
Yeah.
There you go.
See?
Everybody
asked them before the show, and they all know. I think as you get older as well, you get better at tuning in. Shar, thank you so much for that lesson today.
Thank you. You know what? I teach this, and if people want to go to my website, shar.net, they can see when I'm going to do a class here eventually.
Very good. And we can learn more about getting in touch with it. Let's go to break.
Thank
you. We got more coming up.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's good.